Don't let it keep you from progressing. Whatever happens, don't let it shock you. It's gonna have that effect. Process it, but don't let it prevent you from progressing. Stop for a minute and think about this. You have survived it. You've survived it and come out on the other side of it. So keep in mind that you have now overcome that crisis. You may have done some things that you wish you hadn't have done. You may have wished there were some things that would have happened differently. Just keep in mind that you have survived. Putting plans and things into place to either account for it or prevent it from happening again. That when you're put in a position that you've never been exposed to, it challenges your brain to come up with alternatives and options and things to ensure that you've addressed those things. So when you're put into a crisis, maybe this specific crisis itself may never happen in terms of that account again, but all the things that happen that tie collaterally to it, what happens is that it forces you to look critically at your situation and say, this is what happens. I need to start planning to make sure that never happens again. This is what I need to do. So take advantage of this as a great opportunity to plan. Don't give everything away. This is gonna sound kind of crazy, but think of it like this. When you're in a financial crisis, what usually happens is that you'll get a large influx. You may find yourself in a situation where you get a large influx of money, or you're establishing a more predictable stream of income that maybe you didn't have before, whether it be unemployment, whether it be, somebody, a new job, whatever the case may be. There's a natural desire when you're coming out of the crisis to basically pay everything off. Because the idea is that by paying everything off, you're keeping those people at bay, you're satisfying your contractual obligations. I get that. Just keep in mind this. Pull for a little bit for yourself. Now, keep in mind, I'm gonna tell you, I have to give my disclaimer out there as an attorney. Make sure that if you're participating in any need-based programs and saving money may have some impact on it, make sure you find out from them first whether or not that's gonna be a problem. Getting that aside, the reason why I'm saying this is because what happens is that when we come out of a crisis, during that crisis time, we made a lot of decisions to keep the wolves at bay while we're trying to survive. So when you come out, there's a natural desire to try to rush to put all those things back in place or put them back in good standing, so this way you're back to where you used to be. The problem is what ends up happening is you end up benefiting everybody else. You do nothing for yourself. So you want to make sure that you allow yourself some wiggle. Start contacting them and saying, listen, I'm starting to get back on my feet. Is there a way I can progressively get back to there? Keep some for yourself. I'm not saying that you're going to go through another crisis. I'm just saying that keep a little for yourself. So if you get a hiccup as you are trying to progress back to where you were, you're not in a situation where, oh my gosh, now what do I do? Do catch up if you can. Be strategic. Before you start getting what you got and just giving everything away, contact these different people. And I mentioned this before in the other video. Contact these different individuals. See if there's ways that you can progressively do it so that this way you can have the opportunity to get back on your feet in a strategic manner. Try to prioritize what you need to get caught up on. When you're going through a crisis, make sure you don't keep that information to yourself. Make sure people who you owe money to or people you have obligations to are aware that you're dealing with something. But you want to start conditioning them and saying, hey, I'm starting to get some breathing room. It's gonna take me a minute. I'm not sure what a minute is, but it's gonna take me a minute. I got you. Is there anything I can do to show you in good faith that I'm getting back on my feet? Don't act like it won't happen again. I don't want you to get paranoid. Take a hard look at your situation and ask yourself the question, okay, here's the crisis that I'm in. I need to make sure that if anything even remotely similar to that shows its head, that I'm ready for it. So don't fall into this groove of saying, oh man, this will never happen again. I ain't got to worry about this. It's all good in the neighborhood. A crisis is an example of a situation that presents itself that most people are not prepared for. Prepare for it. So this way, if it happens, you can always tell yourself this question, this thing. This is what you prepare for. Do take a breath, breathe and relax. When you come out of a crisis, there is nothing more emotionally, mentally, psychologically, any of the leaves draining than going through a moment like that. When it subsides, when it gives you some breathing room, take a second. Take a look in the mirror. Breathe. Do something that you hadn't done before, or do something you hadn't done in a while. If it's, you know, I know we're in this unique situation and so forth, whether it be ordering a particular type of food, or maybe buying a video game, something that you can do is what I like to call mindless nothing. Why do I call it that? Because you need a break. You need the opportunity to take a second, take a step back, look at your situation and say, okay, now that we've survived that, let me take a breath. Because trust me, there's only one you. And you don't want to beat yourself up or beat yourself down because you've gone through this crisis and now you're in this position where you're so ratcheted up that you haven't given yourself a chance to breathe, relax, and let it go.